Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is about Gilmer's wiring. It is a direct wiring method of intermaxillary fixation between the maxillary and the mandibular teeth. Few firm teeth in the maxilla as well as in the mandible are chosen. This is the most common, simple and practical method.
So firstly we will require a cast, and then we will require a 26 gauge wire, then a twister, then a cutter.
So I'll draw with a pen here for the friction line so that it will be easier for you to understand. So suppose this is the friction line that I'm drawing with the pen. So what you need to know here is that the wire should not be passed in the line of the fracture. Suppose the fracture is between the lateral incisor and canine. So you cannot pass the wire in the lateral incisor and canine region. So you need to pass a wire which is at least one tooth away from the fracture line. So according to Gilmer's wiring rule, we take at least one tooth in the anterior segment. We can take central incisor here. So we are not going to take the lateral and the canine as it involves the line of fracture, I already told you. And in the posterior segment, we need to take minimum one tooth at least. And again, in the another posterior segment, we will be taking another one tooth. It can be molar or premolar. So now pass a wire from the buccal to the lingual side. So here we have selected the central incisor. And again from the lingual to the buccal side in the distal region. So what you need to know here is that in the lingual side in which the wire has been passed, you can take a tweezer, and this should be in the cervical region, not in the middle of the tooth. So always remember this and keep this in mind. Now take the twister, both the wires from the mesial side and the lingual side which you have taken in the buccal side, you need to tie this both together and then twist it together. While twisting it, twist it in a clockwise direction. So now we are done with the anterior tooth. In this same way, we are going to do on the premolar tooth selected in the posterior segment of the right side. So you can select the molar tooth also, or you can select the premolar tooth also. That is up to you. You can see in the video, I am doing the same procedure as I have done in the central incisor region. Now again, we are going to do this in the same premolar of the left side of the segment in the same way. So these are the at least minimum required tooth that we have selected for Gilmer's wiring. But then if you do wiring upon multiple teeth, it will lessen the strain to a particular teeth. To a particular tooth, it will cause less stress or less strain. So therefore here I am going to take another premolar tooth on the right side. And again on the left side, I will be taking another premolar tooth. So at least I will be taking 5 teeth in the mandible. So the same tooth we are going to take in the maxillary region as well. Suppose I have taken mandibular premolar. Then again in the maxillary region, I will take the premolar tooth. Again in the central incisor, I am going to take maxillary central incisor. Again maxillary premolar. So that I can tie both of them together and then form an intermaxillary fixation of the tooth. And I can tie both of the teeth together. Now we will twist all the mandibular wires together tightly with their corresponding maxillary wires. Now cut short the tightly twisted wires of all the wirings done, and then twist them and tuck them in so that it does not impinge the oral mucosa. So finally you are done with your wiring. So one of the main disadvantages of this wiring is requiring complete removal of the wire to open the mouth in emergency situation. So even if you cut out one wire, you cannot open the whole teeth. You need to cut out the whole wire in order to open the tooth, unlike arch bar. Thank you for watching. Please do like, share, subscribe and comment.